thank you, Mr. Chairman. And first of all, I have to disappoint you because the title of my presentation is a different one. It was a kind of misunderstanding between the organizers. And I'm going to speak about the Hungarian policy of the spent fuel management that are used for the MVM Paksmoklár power plant reactors. And I just wanted to show you a little bit different point of view than you have here in Russia, because we are a small country with much less resources in the nuclear field. We don't have any fast reactors, we don't have any reprocessing plants, and we have to buy everything on the market, and we have to wait with our decisions why the new technologies are developed by different countries who has the resources for them. Just a few words about the power plant we have in Paks. We have four 440 units, and they are operating for 30 years now, and we are planning to operate 20 more years of those units. And about 10 years ago we upgraded the plants, and now all the units are operating with 500 megawatt electrical capacity. And quite recently, 1 or 2 years ago, we have changed the traditional 20-month fuel cycle, and now we are working with the 15-month fuel cycle. And we are producing electricity, of course, but we have a byproduct. I will skip those things in order to shorten the presentation. We have a byproduct, which is the spent fuel. And on the four units that we operating right now, we are going to collect more than 17,000 fuel assemblies by the end of the operation of those units. And if we count the units that are under construction, the fifth and sixth units, then we are going to collect 6,000 more fuel assemblies, but they are going to be bigger ones. And altogether, we are going to have 5,000 tons of spent fuel, and we have to solve the destiny of to spend fuel in a very responsible manner. We have a three-step spent fuel policy. The first one is the usual one. We are storing for 3 or 5 years the spent fuel at the spent fuel booth. It's not a strange one. And originally, when we started the operation of the four units, we had a possibility to transfer the spent fuel for reprocessing to the Majak plant without getting back the high-level waste. And that it lasted until the 1980s, and we got rid of more than 2,000 of fuel assemblies at that time. But unfortunately, because of certain political and mainly for economical reasons, we had to stop this approach. And now we are having a different type of second step. We build an interim spent fuel storage facility, and we are just collecting and storing the spent fuel at that facility. And the facility was designed for storing the spent fuel approximately 50 years. And now we have collected already 9,000 fuel assemblies there. And the third step, which is the most important one, but this is not solved yet. The long-term solution is still uncertain. We have a present reference scenario for this third step for the long-term solution, which is a direct disposal in a Hungarian deep geological formation. But this is a reference scenario. We are using this only for financial calculation, because at present it seems that it is the most cheapest one if we calculate the price of the final solution today. A few words about the interim storage facility. It was commissioned in 1997. It is a modular and wall-type dry storage facility. Modular means that we are continuously expanding this storage facility as we are collecting the spent fuel. Here you can see that we have already 5 modules built, and we are still expanding this one. And the individual fuel assemblies are stored in tubes, and the tubes are filled with inert nitrogen atmosphere, and the cooling is provided by the bacillia. Here on this sketch you can see the cooling seam of the storage facility, and who is familiar with the dry storage at the GHK we have just seen in one of the pictures, you can notice that it's more or less similar way of cooling the storage tubes like it was done 2 years ago at the GHK. A few words about the final disposal facility. As I mentioned, no final decision has been made on the management of the spent nuclear fuel, but it is clear that we have to construct a deep geological repository in Hungary because we have to store all kinds of high-level waste. Even in case of reprocessing, we are going to get back the vitrified waste, and we have to store it somewhere. There is a so-called Buda clay stone formation, which is a possible site that was selected for this repository. It was investigated many years ago as part of the Mecsek uranium mine, and the investigation process was resumed 2003, and we plan to build a geological disposal facility in the depth of 500 or 900 meters somewhere here under the ground. And according to our recent plans, we have to establish an underground research laboratory at that site about 2030, and later on we are going to start the construction and the commissioning of that facility. We don't have to forget that MPP is operating within the European Union, so all the regulation coming from the European Union have to be applied for our solutions. And there is a council directive establishing a community framework for the responsible and safe management of the spent fuel and radioactive waste, and we have to apply that directive. There are many things listed in that. One I wanted to underline, that according to this one, the export of radioactive waste for disposal in countries outside the European Union is allowed, but only under strict condition. It's practically cannot be fulfilled right now. But according to this directive, we had to set up a national program about the management of the spent fuel, and this national program is still a what-if type of program, because we listed three possible scenarios according to this program. The scenario A is the simplest one, but we don't want to carry out, of course, this one, the direct disposal of the spent fuel, but as I mentioned, we still have this as a reference scenario for the financial calculation. The scenario B is reprocessing of the spent fuel, with or without interim storage somewhere. It depends when we are starting the reprocessing. If we are starting the reprocessing right now or tomorrow, then afterwards we have to store somewhere the vitrified high-level waste, because we don't have a storage for that. If we start the reprocessing after the operation of the plants, then we have to expand the interim storage facility, but we don't have to solve the interim storage of the vitrified waste. And there is the scenario C, which is the advanced reprocessing of the spent fuel, with the separation of the minor actinides. We have many presentations today, but we still feel that it is, in the short term, industrially not available, at least not for us at this moment, so we cannot count on that in a short term. Another thing we have to take into account in our national program, that the use of any reprocessed fuel is not feasible on the recently operating units. The recently operating VVL 440 units are not prepared for using any kind of MOX or MX fuel, so we think that this type of fuel could be used only for the new units, the VVL 1200 units that are under construction. And the third one I already mentioned, that we think that we have to construct a deep geological repository in Hungary in any case, but of course in case of reprocessing, this, the size and the requirements against that repository would be smaller than in the other case. And just as a last words about the financing, there is a central Dupla financing fund in Hungary, which is a separated state fund, and it is under the supervision of the Ministry of National Development. And according to our legislation, all users of nuclear energy generating radioactive waste or spent fuel during their activity shall bear the cost of the waste management. So this is why the Paksukar power plant has to pay into that fund every year. And from this separate state fund, we are financing, or the country is financing different tax. From this fund is financed the expansion of the interim storage for the spent fuel. From this fund is financed the final disposal of the low and medium level rad waste. From this fund we are going to finance the solution for the spent fuel and building the high level waste repository. And from this fund we are going to finance the preparation and the decommissioning itself of our facilities. And here you can see that practically half of this fund is going to spend on the spent on the long-term solution with the spent fuel. Unfortunately, the new units that are under construction are not paying yet into the fund, but they are going to pay only in the case they start the operation, which is going to be within 6, 7, 8, I don't know how many years. And until then, the annual payment is calculated based on the cost estimation of the long-term program we have in our, our national program, taking into account the actual discount rates. It means that any solution which should be carried out in a short term, it costs much higher than the solution we have to carry out after 20 or 25 years. So this is why, for instance, the retrocessing solution, starting from the next day, it's really expensive for us, because against that solution we can calculate the building of a deep geological repository after 30 or 40 years. So with that, I would like to conclude my presentation. I hope it was short enough. I skipped many slides because of shape time for you and to reach the gala dinner for you.